worship that for me. When a function is on, they scarcely go at all, and they're both born organisers. In fact, they're here tonight, just helping out as usual. Father Turner, Council George Davis, a good stone shelters, and I don't know how we could have managed without their input. When he comes to Sonia, Sonia Norman, she's the choir behind the office, but always goes that extra mile that finishes being flat. In July this year, Kat and I were invited to the Queen's Garden Party of the Forest. I've invited her to a lovely art house. She hasn't invited her, but I suppose she'd be busy with the wedding. I'm speaking of the Royal Wedding. All those that have got the gift of lip reading, did you notice Prince Harry telling some of his guests they were all going back to his nan's house because he put on a voting for the family? He's just like us, he's an only man living extraordinary things. I have to tell you now that I've retired from the Borough Council, as well as giving up the mayoralty. And when I pass the chain of office to Councillor McLaughlin, that will signify the end of my council career and the end of an era for me. At this point, you're not far. Traumatic events within my family in the last year or so. And that's made me reevaluate my life and refocus, and that's triggered my reasons for standing down. So all in all, I've had a very enjoyable time as a councillor, and it's been an honour to represent the people of Clatterbridge Ward. I've been lucky enough to have made friends across all political parties and quite across the borough. And on that note, I will wish Moira a very happy year of change, and I will only thank you. Tomorrow I will be having a new baby, as Kath will be out all day with her sister, and that means the house to myself, the TV remote to myself, a couch to myself, and a six pack of cheese and onion crisps. How good is that? If only the cat could make coffee, it would be perfect. Ladies and gentlemen, aldermen, past mayors, councillors, honoured guests, I give a heartfelt thank you to our borough for. And now it gives me great pleasure to present Wirral's young poet laureate, Kim Morgan, who will read one of their poems for us. Kim, if you're ready. she was born, Dad looked at Mum and said, "Oh, let's call it a day." That, gratefully they didn't, and Mum became the mayor of four children. Sadly, Bridie was diagnosed with MS, and Dad being away at sea times weren't that easy. But beloved Nancy Irene played a major part in Mum's upbringing, and she wanted her to be mentioned in the speech tonight. Both parents encouraged Mum in the importance of education, something she probably didn't appreciate at the time, but now remembers. And her main education was as a common girl. I won't go into common girl, guys. I've got very Catholic grammar. Despite being encouraged to go down my career paths, Mum knew she wanted to be a nurse. At 16, she left. 18, nurse training begins. By the age of 22, she was a respected ward sister at Batterbridge. Mum then went on to give 41 years of dedicated service, not only to have a 6-year break to have children, which will come on to later. Always passionate, her motto was dignity and respect for every single one. Patients, no matter what the circumstances. Lifelong friendships developed. People here are from the W ward when she first started, although years ago as friends. So I asked Moira, I didn't really, it made me suffer. I asked Moira, why nursing? Was it the uniform? Well, it wasn't the money, of course. No, she said, needles. And with a glint in her eyes, she says, it's better to give than receive. Also behind me is a gag, which I'll throw in. Sorry folks, careful. A doctor, a nurse, and a hospital manager find themselves at the early gates. So St. Peter comes down and says, "Right doctor, what have you done?" He says, "Well, I've waited all my life and saved hundreds of lives." "Oh, that's credibility. Come inside." The nurse says, "Well, I help the doctor. And I must care for thousands and thousands of people and got them better." And St. Peter says, "Come inside." Next, the hospital manager says, "Oh, I've put almost a thousand people through the system. I've done all I can to help people get better." St. Peter says, "Very creditable. Come inside, but only for 2 nights." And that's good. Moira became active in politics as a reaction to election of Maggie Thatcher. So that's another thing we got Maggie Thatcher to blame for. Trade unions was exactly the 1980s, and I remember one of the most vividly when we had our backs against the wall under the re-selection of Frank Field. Very tough, difficult time. Moira was part of a group of very loyal people, and that loyalty has stayed through. And that loyalty has returned back to Moira from Frank Field, who's a great supporter of Moira. I know passion's about to be there this time around. But all her heart and soul, using her background, is adult social care. And yes, she has brought many improvements. And yes, never far away from controversy, adult social care. She has continued to keep those mottos about dignity and respect for everyone this board serves. And she's also kept her own personal integrity, to the point where she was recognised nationally for the role of the LGA. And hopefully, she'll continue that after the next year. However, the board never claims her biggest achievement, quite likely, to be a family. She has 4 grown-up daughters, 4 grandchildren. Moira has instilled in them a sense of fairness, a good work ethic, and a commitment to putting something back. So it's not by chance that Anna, who we know as a former elected member, is a social worker, Catherine, a teacher, Laura, an occupational therapist, and Claire, a homelessness prevention officer. We've got them on there, I apologise. But all I say to that family, watch out, you might get privatised. She also has another mother in her life, which is Bevan, a cat, named after my Bevan. Strange, strange. So, I've given you just a merest glimpse of what Moira is about. She's going to be on the next pair, and she's worked tirelessly as sexy there, and assisted by Anna in the daughter, she's done really well. She's told me she feels immense pride in becoming a mayor, and I know she'll do a fantastic job. I'm proud of this woman, everyone in this room is proud of this woman, and I know we'll all end up being proud of Moira when she does leave here as mayor. Thanks so much. Thank you.
photos after this, so I'll move a bit closer so I can get a photo. She's probably got a speech, then we've got to do the deputy in there, and then I'll pretty much be it. I don't want to stop it.